You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
All writers are prone to becoming so attached to our characters and stories that we struggle to see why a passage may not be working. It takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing to full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, shaping stories into masterpieces that can stand the test of time. Editing services are provided for all genres and all age categories. Services range from critiques of the short story through to the line edits of the full-length novel and copy editing for those preparing for publication. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your website, as well as help with those book blurbs and promotional material. We won't abandon you to the masses. We want to celebrate with you and your successes. Black Wolf Editorial Services. Nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services and prices, visit us at blackwolfeditorial.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Let all make the ride this storm. Put my hands for the coming dawn. Up to our next Happy Tuesday. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson. We're coming to you live right now from KLRNradio.com. Want to thank everybody for taking time to tune in with us this evening. Also want to give a moment to give a shout-out to all of the affiliates. We have Red Nation Rising Radio, the Liberty Channel, where this show can be heard every Monday through Friday at 6 a.m. Eastern. We have the AMFM247.com group, where the show can be heard every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 1 p.m. Eastern. Sorry. And then we have Lanterns Radio Network, where the show can now be heard every Monday through Friday at 2 p.m. Eastern. And, of course, we have the CRN Radio Group, where the show can be heard every Saturday and Sunday at 10 p.m. Eastern, 9 p.m. Central, 7 p.m. Pacific. And, of course, the show is available on iHeart, iTunes, Stitcher, SoundCloud, FM Player, Google Play Music, and about a half a dozen others that I'm not able to think of right now. But my guest that I have coming on in just a second can actually help with that. We have Jess from Jess's POV who will be hanging out with us, and since her show's simulcast almost everywhere mine is, she probably knows a lot of the players a little more than I do. So, good evening, Miss Jess. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good, Rick. How are you?
I am hanging in there. Suddenly sounds like you have a bit of a frog in your throat. So now I think...
Of course, Mr. Frog had to make his regularly unannounced, unscheduled, unwanted appearance tonight.
Well, I'm a sympathetic frogger, so I may join you now. Yay. All right, yay. So anyway. All right. How are you? You seem to have a bit of an echo.
Not bad. It's what a new year. We went out with a dumpster fire. We're coming in with a threatened ICBM launch from the Hermit Kingdom.
Yeah, well. Are you hearing that echo, or is that just me?
Just me.
Is that better, Rick?
Well, it's only doing it when I talk, so I'm trying to track it down, because I seem to be getting a bit of a feedback from one of your panels, but I think it may be under control now.
Okay, I turned off some of the looping on my board.
Yeah, I think the looping was probably what did it. But anyway, so it's not a big surprise that, you know, the North Korean midget suddenly deciding he's going to try to lob a missile. He only makes that threat about once every 5 years or so, but this time it does seem a little more serious than others. So I guess that's part of the reason why you're here.
I have to say it's a lot more serious than usual.
Uh-oh. See, I knew you were going to say that.
I'm not using it just on my own speculation. First of all, we have the Department of Defense saying some unusual things. I don't have the audio prepared. They gave, of course, the standard lines. We've got the missile defense to protect, blah, 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 you know, the usual playbook speech about, yes, we've got this under control. But then they do an evacuation drill with a large number of military families living in Korea, in South Korea. I've been over there as a military spouse. In all my time there on the peninsula, no one I knew had ever been through an evacuation drill.
Wait, no one you knew?
No one. And we're talking, I regularly talk to the guards from the DMZ. Their families had never been through an evacuation drill. And if any families would be involved in an evacuation drill, our guards that literally stand on the border. For those who are not familiar with the acronym DMZ, Demilitarized Zone, it is a 2 mile wide strip, which, despite its name, is the most militarized zone in Korea, north or south. There are landmines. There are plenty of troops on both sides ready to start screaming, yelling, shooting, and all kinds of other antics with each other. The DMZ has been site of many provocations, incidents, arrests, exchanges of bodies, return of, a couple years ago, it was used for a good purpose. It was a military helicopter that had crashed on North Koreans. It crashed just over the 38th parallel, which is in the northern side of the 38th parallel, for those who are not familiar with Korean geography, is North Korea. And the living pilot was returned a few days after his crew member's body. So they did return the body, and then a few days later, they returned the pilot. He was missing a couple of his uniform patches, but didn't have any visible bruises on him on the news footage I saw. And they literally just walked him across to the Pam Moon John building and walked him across the DMZ. So it's been used for good stuff. Now, no one crosses the Bridge of No Return anymore. It said that thing is bombed.
So wait, just for folks that are maybe not familiar with the area, they actually have a bridge called the Bridge of No Return?
The Bridge of No Return was used for prisoner exchanges at the end of the Korean War. The prisoners were all put in the middle of the bridge, and you could walk to either side. And once you made up your decision, that was it. Now, what's interesting, and I've been to the DMZ tour a number of times, and I've talked to a number of people, and if you can probably see this in enough YouTube videos if you go looking for it. There's usually a few dead dogs on the North Korean side of the Bridge of No Return. Now, first of all, North Korean people are starving. Why would they leave dead carcasses around? And these dead carcasses don't rot. So that tells me they're probably actually, oh, what's the term when you get something stuffed and mounted?
Taxidermy?
That's it. They're probably taxidermy dogs, and it's believed they're filled with explosives.
Wait, seriously?
Yes. Okay, just to give you an idea of the insanity, the DMZ was the demilitarized zone was the site of the world's most expensive tree trimming or tree cutting down operation, I should say. It's Operation Paul Bunyan. And this was back in the 70s when things were a little bit less technical and more dependent on actual people doing actual looking. There was a tree that was blocking line of sight from checkpoint one, checkpoints three to four, anyway, between two checkpoints. So the U.S. military sent word, however they do it, to the North Koreans. We're going to trim this tree on date X. Well, North Korean forces came across the divide. And I don't remember if they crossed the Bridge of No Return or not, but they came across and attacked the U.S. Military members that were doing the tree trimming and killed one. Well, America couldn't let that go, could they, Rick?
Well, no.
So, Operation Paul Bunyan was announced. The entire peninsula was put on high alert. We had military aircraft carrier off the coast. We had overflight, overwatch, everything. And the U.S. military went in and cut the tree down. Now, if that isn't the world's most expensive tree trimming, I don't know what is when you put not one, but two militaries on alert, and you bring in air assets and naval assets and everything else just to chop down a tree.
So wait, all that just to chop down a tree? Really?
Yes, because people have been killed trying to trim it. So the U.S. said, tree's gone. We're done. And I believe, if my memory serves, Operation Paul Bunyan was in 1976, but I'm double checking. And it was after the axe murder incident, because they used the tools that the people that were trimming the tree were going to use to cut the tree down to kill them. Yes, it was in August 18th, 1976 that the attack happened. And then the reaction was Operation Paul Bunyan. And President Ford came up with Operation Paul Bunyan. And like I said, it was 3 days afterwards, 23 American and South Korean vehicles drove into the area without warning. And 2 8-man teams of military engineers from the 2nd Engineer Battalion, 2nd Infantry Division, equipped with chainsaws, cut down the tree. Accompanying those teams were two 30-man security platoons from the Joint Security Force. The second platoon secured the north entrance to the Joint Security Area, the JSA, via the Bridge of No Return, while the third platoon secured the southern edge of the area. And there was also, like I said, there was aircraft overflights, 20 utility helicopters, 7 Cobra attack helicopters, the B-52 Stratofortress, the F-4 Phantom, and South Korean F-5 and F-86 fighter jets all took part in Operation Paul Bunyan.
Wow.
I told you it was the most expensive tree trimming in the world, Rick.
Definitely seems that way.
I mean, really? Really? It was the most expensive tree trimming in the world. I guarantee it. But Ford was like, nah. If we can't go trim this tree on a regular basis and do it safely, that tree won't be there. Now, they did leave what they've done with the area since then. Because there was a lieutenant that was killed, Lieutenant Mark Barrett, and they have a memorial plaque for the victims and a cement circle that the size of the tree trunk, and it's considerable size. And I've actually seen the plaque. So yeah, if those military families who live there, right by the DMZ, have never had an evacuation drill. Okay, what are they doing evacuation drills with families in Seoul and further south? If the U.S. military isn't worried.
That is a very good question.
That is a very good question.
So, I mean, it's... If you've never, and for those of you listening, if you've never been to the DMZ, it is very much a surreal experience. Yes, you do technically get to step into North Korean territory, but you do it inside the Military Armistice Commission building, which is the building that was built in the 1950s for the negotiations. If you remember the episodes of MASH that they're going to Panmunjom about the negotiations. This is the real Panmunjom, the real building. And literally the table is exactly on the border. Half of the table is in North Korea. Half of the table is in South Korea. There are microphones on in that building 24/7 that are recorded. And everything in that building is right on the border. When you're on the tour, which is sponsored by the USO, so it is safe to do. It's not some gray market, black market thing. You actually enter the building, but there are South Korean soldiers guarding you all around, as well as the U.S. Armed Forces. And all of the South Korean DMZ guards, first of all, they're taller than the average South Korean. They're all black belts. And the whole time they're standing watch up at the DMZ, they are in a Taekwondo fighting stance. You don't mess with them. So you can technically walk into North Korea, even if it's only a few steps in, just to take your picture on the other side of the 38th parallel. But that's about as far as I've ever been. Unless we have regime change or reunification, that's as far as I'm going. I have crossed North Korea off my tourist list, right next to Tehran and Syria.
Well, I'm kind of surprised it was ever on your travel list. Insane.
I've always had a fascination with closed countries. What can I say? The Hermit Kingdom fascinates me. Now, China is the one, and if you don't know this, China should be the one pulling North Korea's chain, right?
Yeah, I mean, I think everybody knows that.
All right.
The international community is galvanized like it's never been before. Does that mean that every country is implementing every single one of the sanctions that are in place on any or every given day? Of course not. But that doesn't mean that we don't want to see that happen. And it doesn't mean that the sanctions that are being implemented are, in fact, still the most stringent that have been in place in the last 20 years. So
he just went on umming for another minute. I cut it off. But yeah, the sanctions in place are designed to literally hit North Korea where it hurts. They've sanctioned North Korea's only real export, besides defectors anyway. There were 30,000 of those.
Wait, so there were 30,000 defectors? Is that what you just said?
Yeah, last year.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. And the most high profile was the second in charge at the London embassy.
Wait, so the number two guy at the London embassy for them defected last year?
Yeah.
That's awesome. I had no idea.
Yes. Yes. It was amazing. And of course, North Korea immediately started up the propaganda machine, which of course they're experts at the propaganda machine. They manufactured a whole backstory for Kim Jong-un out of whole nothing cloth. I mean, it's just the stuff that they have manufactured has been absolutely, positively beyond belief. Now, here's another audio clip talking about China.
It is, what I will say about China is that it is clear that they are absolutely concerned about the direction that Pyongyang is taking. And one shouldn't be surprised by that. I mean, the DPRK is a southern neighbor and they share a border. They have been concerned about sanctions in the past because their southern provinces do direct business in North Korea. But they did sign up to these very robust sanctions, and they have publicly committed to implementing those sanctions, and that's going to be our expectation going forward.
Two last questions. To your knowledge...
They were droning on about this stuff. I mean, and this stuff went on for ages.
Oh, boy.
I mean, these conferences I pull sound clips from, Rick, they go on for about an hour. Now, I do have a couple of DOD clips. Like I said, they're mostly the standard party line. But they're still worth playing. Oh, I've got one. Here we go.
Bob. Peter, Kim Jong-un says that they're getting close to having a ballistic missile of intercontinental range. And my question is, what is the Defense Department's policy at the moment if North Korea were to test launch a missile of intercontinental range? Would the Defense Department attempt to shoot it down?
Well, first of all, Bob, as you know, multiple UN Security Council resolutions explicitly prohibit North Korea's launches using ballistic missile technology or further development of a ballistic missile program. And we call on all states to use every channel, available channel, means of influence to make clear to the North Korea and its enablers that launches using ballistic missile technology or efforts to advance North Korea's ballistic missile capabilities are unacceptable. We further call on all states to take steps to show that there are consequences to the DPRK's unlawful conduct. And we call on the DPRK to refrain from provocative actions and to make the strategic choice to fulfill its international obligations and commitments and return to serious talks. And we reaffirm our ironclad commitments to defend our allies utilizing the full spectrum of U.S. extended deterrence capabilities. Bob.
All right, Rick, do you remember the North? I don't know if you keep up with this stuff as much as I do, but back in, I believe it was September, the DPRK did a nuclear test. They actually tested a nuclear warhead in an underground tunnel.
They tested a nuclear warhead in an underground tunnel?
Yeah, because you realize you have the firing mechanism for these things is actually a very precise science, and if all the explosives aren't aligned right, you don't get maximum yield. Well, the estimates were that this warhead was approximately 20 kilotons. While that is relatively small compared to a lot of the warheads that the U.S. and Russia have, that's still a lot. So then, of course, everybody condemned the test, and that's what brought about the latest U.N. sanctions on their on North Korea's coal exports. Now, North Korea claims, and nobody's sure, but we won't be, there's no way for us to be sure, they claim they have miniaturized this warhead enough to fit it on one of their larger missiles. Now, the problem with North Korea isn't their warhead capabilities, Rick. It's their missile capabilities. They have trouble getting a missile to go up and come down where they want it.
Yeah, I mean, I've heard that their biggest issue with their missiles is they don't really have a very good guidance system, so.
Oh, no, it's called set the coordinates for the missile, launch it, and cross your fingers. It's worse than our server, Rick. It's worse than bubblegum and kite string.
Yeah,
only has bubblegum.
Yeah, I mean, you know, everybody knows you got to have at least bubblegum and kite string to make things work, so somebody needs to send them a memo.
Thanks, I'll pass.
come on, why not? All right, so believe it or not, we are already at the bottom of the hour. We're going to have to take a really quick break. When we come back, even more about what's going on around the world and the crazy things that are going on in North Korea. And I think you actually had another topic you wanted to talk about, too. We can change gears with that here in a little bit when we get back, too. But this is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson. We'll be right back here in just a couple of minutes.
You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
All writers are prone to becoming so attached to our characters and stories that we struggle to see why a passage may not be working. It takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing to full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, shaping stories into masterpieces that can stand the test of time. Editing services are provided for all genres and all age categories. Services range from critiques of the short story through to the line edits of the full-length novel and copy editing for those preparing for publication. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your website, as well as help with those book blurbs and promotional material. We won't abandon you to the masses. We want to celebrate with you and your successes. Black Wolf Editorial Services. Nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services and prices, visit us at blackwolfeditorial.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 of pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Hey, folks. I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Hardin. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at rahardin.com. That's the World Wide Web at rahardin.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Hardin to see and purchase his books.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
All right, folks, welcome back, and this is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson, again joined by my very special guest, a host around these parts as well, Miss Jessica Sanders, host of Jesse's POV, and we have been, actually she has been, while I've been tracking down some gremlins, talking mostly about North Korea and some very interesting stories from there, like the fact that apparently there was an Operation Paul Bunyan, I think was what you said it was, which was amazing to me because I had no idea that we spent all that money on chopping down trees. But anyway, it doesn't really...
Just one time, Rick. It was a one-time operation to get rid of a tree so nobody else got killed trying to trim it.
Yeah, well, and still, one of those
President
things.
Trump did it.
Yeah, somehow that doesn't really surprise me either. All right, so you said you had some stuff you wanted to talk about with the recent activity in the House since this, I believe, was their first official day back in session.
Yes, today was the start of the 115th.
Yep.
House. Now, there was a big kerfluffle over the rules. Because Republicans, having the majority in the House, proposed some new rules. And one of the things that was proposed was, if you live stream, you know, you pull out your cell phone and you start live streaming on Facebook or Twitter or wherever you want from your phone, you are subject to a $2,500 fine. Now, there's always been rules of decorum in place, but it's always been up to the party bosses to enforce them. And the rules had no teeth. Well, needless to say, the Democrats were not too impressed with this. And this came about as a result of the sit-in. Now, what I found amusing was that some of the senators didn't even realize that live stream technology was available until the sit-in.
I mean, come on, most of our senators are ancient, so of course they didn't know what all technology was available.
I know, but it was just kind of amusing. And the Democrats are saying that this rules package violates the First Amendment.
That's an interesting stance. Isn't it always funny how it's always the opposition party that starts throwing around the Constitution?
And of course, there's it also included the fact that lawsuits against the Affordable Care Act, aka Obamacare, can continue. And so, of course, they were between putting down the rule about live streaming from the floor and screaming about how that violated the First Amendment and yelling about Obamacare, they were all up in ruckus today.
So they were having a meltdown, huh?
Oh, the Dems were melting.
Such a disturbing tone for our new session of Congress. It requires authorizing committees to propose programs that should be moved from mandatory to discretionary. Now, what does that mean? Mandatory programs must be funded. Must. Discretionary programs do not have to be funded. It is a calculated move to cut vital programs like Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, and Pell Grants. As a member of the Appropriations Committee, I know that we do not even have the discretionary money, the dollars to support the current programs in place. Medical research at the National Institutes of Health has been cut by $7.5 billion since 2003. These rules as also deny members their freedom of speech. They institute potentially unconstitutional mechanisms to punish members for speaking their minds on the floor of this House and delivering a message to people. Our constituents elect us to speak our minds on the floor of this House. It is wrong. It's a disgrace. It is the wrong way to start a new session. This represents the total denunciation.
Gentlelady's time has expired.
As members of Congress, I yield back the balance of my
time. Gentlelady's time.
How's that for a ruckus, Rick?
Yeah, definitely sounds like a bit of a meltdown.
Oh, and I mean, and this went on for an hour and a half in 1 and 2 minute bursts.
Nice.
I mean, because, you know, the most anybody really had was like 2 minutes with the exception. And it was just absolutely, yeah. And that was the congresswoman, I think from Colorado, or no, it was Connecticut, excuse me. But yeah, she was just absolutely losing the plot.
Well, I mean, to be fair, yeah, this has been kind of a recurring thing for them because, you know, I've noticed it a lot, especially with the millennials, especially the younger millennials who've grown up under President Obama. They really, really thought this was going to be the new age, the new golden age for liberalism. And
I got one for you. Let me get this one queued up. It'll take me just a second.
Sure.
This one I tripped over. And it's not, I will say, it's not real recent. It's about 2 years old. And I don't even know how I tripped over this story. This woman who is living on welfare has 15 kids by at least three different men. Now, here's, I've got two audio clips.
In my case, they done been in my life 6 months and I'm homeless.
37-year-old Angel Adams blames the system for her problems, a system of social service agencies trying to help her. Adams has 15 children, 12 who are now living with her in this small motel room.
All right, that clip was bad. Wait till you hear the next one, Rick.
Somebody needs to pay for all my children and my and Gary, all our suffering, all our pain. Somebody needs to be held accountable.
How's that for your millennial meltdown?
Wait, so just so I can make sure I heard that right. She's saying that somebody needs to pay her for all of her children and someone needs to be held accountable for their pain and suffering.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's not how this works.
The Department of Human Services put her through because they're trying to help her.
So how exactly did Department of Human Services cause her pain and suffering?
Oh, because she ended up homeless after having ignoring eviction notice. I watched the whole story and it was like 20 minutes on this YouTube video the station had pinned together. And it was just, okay, we start off with she's in the hotel room with the 12 kids, has nothing because all of her stuff was literally thrown out of her apartment because she ignored the eviction notices. And when she had to leave, she just grabbed what she could. Well, first of all, Rick, you don't ignore an eviction notice. And the apartment complex was basically evicting her because 15 kids in a two-bedroom apartment.
Yeah, that's against most DHS standards that I know of.
Right. So then, you know, she contacted DHS like 6 months prior for help. They'd paid her rent, gotten her furniture, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So then the news station calls DHS going, well, what can you do for this lady? So they find her a place where she can live with her kids temporarily. Well, then they go to court to assess the situation, a whole team of social workers and all this, that, and everything else. And the judge asks her, are you pregnant now? And she refuses to answer. So the judge throws her in jail. Now, she just kept her there for one night. But it seemed one night did the trick, because the next day she was singing like a bird and all. Wait a minute. I did wrong. I'm sorry. Well, then her children had to stay in the shelter and the rules only allowed her to stay for a few days because it's like a 72-hour thing where she could stay, but the kids could stay longer. So she had to leave, but she was allowed to come visit the kids as long as she picked up the phone, called the shelter and said, hey, I'm on my way. No problem. Her brother had said, move in with me. Well, then he backed out because in his words, she ignores advice from everybody around her trying to help. So why should I do anything for her?
Well, I mean, you know, when you won't take anybody else's advice and then you want to do nothing but sit around and whine, I mean, kind of, I mean, I don't know what else to say about that other than that's completely crazy to me. It's somebody that keeps
living on welfare and wants us to foot the bill for all 15 of her kids.
Yeah, because we made her have 15 kids. It's all our fault. But yeah, I mean, you just, I don't know. It goes back to something that Jen and I were talking about in the last hour. We have basically created an entire generation and now heading towards two generations of entirely entitled people. They feel like the world owes them something. And if they don't get what they think they're owed, then they're just never happy. I don't understand that mindset. I really don't. I've tried. I really have. But I don't understand this idea that just because you're here, the world owes you something. The world doesn't owe you anything. It's up to you every day to determine what your best course of action is going to be to get you where you yourself want to be. Not sit around like this lady was and gripe and moan and complain because nobody's helping her take care of her 15 kids. Well, somebody helped you make some of those 15 kids, so maybe you should be talking to the people that helped create those children and figure out why it is they're not willing to help you take care of them instead of blaming it on someone else. And actually, Ron just pointed out that it's not just a generation at this point. It's basically an entire society, which I'm not sure I agree with, but I understand the sentiment because it just seems like we've gotten to the point where everybody feels like they're owed something or entitled to something when in reality they're absolutely entitled to nothing.
Okay, your parents, when you're a child, and I'm talking, you know, little kid, I'm talking like newborn to say 4 years old. Yeah, it's expected your parents will take care of everything for you. Does that mean they have to give in to every whim? Every whine? No. What do they have to do? Feed you, clothe you, and house you. And make sure you don't hurt yourself. Am I wrong? Am I missing something there, Rick?
No, that's pretty much it. That's ultimately what your parents are responsible for, is to make sure that you have some form of roof over your head, some sort of food supply, and that you have clothing so that you don't violate decency standards for the community that you live in. Now, for those of you who don't seem to understand how this works, that means that ultimately you're only required to provide basic sustenance. I actually had this conversation with some folks way back in the day when I used to wear a uniform and was explaining, you know, you're legally obligated to do these things. That means that if you decide to do nothing more than these things, there's absolutely nothing anybody can do. So, and I've actually talked to people that have unruly children and made these suggestions, you know, get rid of their electronic devices. They don't need them. Most of the time you pay for them. So why should they have them if they're going to continue to disrespect you? They're not entitled to those things. You give them to them as a privilege. They're not a requirement. Now, a lot of folks look at a cell phone differently nowadays because it's an instant means of communication. It's up to you if or when the child decides to leave the house, if whether or not you're going to decide they have access to their cell phone. But as long as they have somewhere safe and dry and typically warm or relatively cool to sleep, and they have access to food, which can be limited to bread and water, used to work in prisons, can work for your children when they're grounded, and they have basic clothing, that's really the only things that you are required by law to provide them. Now, I'm not telling you to do bread and water, but it's a nice thing to keep in your back pocket when you have an unruly teenager and suddenly you're like, hey, why don't you, this is your dinner for the night. No, I've never actually done that, but I have threatened it. Usually the threat's enough.
Oh, by the way, Rick, have you heard about the latest rehab treatments and what they're for?
No, I have not.
Rehab for millennials struggling with failure to launch.
Wait, rehab for millennials struggling with what?
Failure to launch. In other words, failure to grow up and get out of the house.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yes.
You know, for all these people that are wondering why we have this entire group of folks that don't have any coping skills and no way to really do anything beyond basic everyday activities. It's because we have an entire generation of folks that were never taught any type of critical thinking. Now, I have to admit, some of that actually started going away during my generation. So it took me a little while to find my feet as well, because towards the end of my high school and the beginning of my college career, the indoctrination stuff had already even started here. So it took a while. But one of the things that I've noticed that was missing is we don't have the ability to do what is called critical thinking. And for those of you that aren't sure what I'm talking about not necessarily book smarts and being able to recall information and recite it on demand. I'm talking about the ability to decide from day to day things that matter and are important. You know, where should I get a job? What do I need to be able to do that job? Can I balance my checkbook? Can I keep track of my money? Do I have the ability to do the things that I'm trying to do to make sure that I survive? All of those things require critical thinking, which nobody gets taught anymore in public education.
Well, that's why they now have rehab programs.
Yeah, we have a rehab program so people can learn critical thinking, because our high schools and elementary schools and junior schools and college.
Evanston, Illinois, for millennials struggling with, quote, failure to launch syndrome and other issues such as mood and anxiety disorders that prevent them from becoming functioning adults in society. Called Yellow Brick, it aims to address the unique challenges of the emerging adult population through programs that emphasize multi-specialty evaluation, therapeutic residences, research-based strategies, and life intervention skills.
I wonder how much they're charging them for this.
It is $27,000 a month.
Wait, you had to have said that wrong. Did you literally just say $27,000 a month?
Uh-huh. And it's some insurances will cover it.
All of it or some of it?
Depends on your insurance.
Well, I can guarantee you Obamacare ain't covering that. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I just say that out loud?
Of course you did. Oh. I mean, it's just nuts. It's nuts. And let's see. What else does this say about failure to launch? A lot of patients come from affluent homes, the privileged, and were just never able to handle the real world. Surprise you?
No, not really.
Now, this program has evidently been in existence for over 10 years, as of the date of this article. And that this article was January 2nd, 2017.
So it's been around since about 2007. So yeah, I mean, right about the time that the whole lack of critical thinking kind of became evident pretty much everywhere. Ron in the chat has a question. Is it covered by Medicare?
I doubt it. So there's a curfew at 11 unless you call and say you're going to be late. And there's no lockdown. Though if you come home drunk or judged to be a danger to yourself, there's a quiet room with soft chairs and a white noise machine for you on the first floor.
Nice.
And less immediate, there's an intro to psychology textbook on the coffee table in the basement level apartment. There's less immediate threatening forms of rule breaking, such as coupling, skipping too many groups, bullying, and they're considered opportunities to grow. You fill out a worksheet during a community meeting, you come to understand the offending behavior is a symptom of your core enactment, the center's shorthand for all bad habits and destructive patterns. Now, recently, Yellow Brick, a center mentioned in this article, analyzed the data from their patients over the past 10 years and found the following: nearly all who came in with moderate and severe levels of depression and anxiety improved to having only mild levels at time of completion. Nearly all showed significant improvement in attention, memory, executive functioning, problem solving, and decision making. Nearly all showed in significant improvement in ability to effectively manage their home, time, and money. And nearly all were either employed or going to college or technical school within 2 to 4 years after completing treatment.
Well, I mean, if it's working, what's $27,000 a month between friends?
I'm sorry, but this is, in my mind, this is the biggest ripoff scam going. Oh, and by the way, there's a subtext to this. It says white privilege? ?
Nice. So they had to find a way to throw in the right white privilege thing. All right, folks. Well, believe it or not, we are officially out of time. Jess, as we always do, as we're trying to run for the door, why don't you remind folks where it is that they can hang out with you when you're not hanging out with me on the radio?
You can find me on Twitter at Jesse's POV, and you can catch me Monday through Friday at 9 o'clock at night on Jesse's POV.
All right, folks. Well, we are officially late to get out of here, so we've got to make room. We've got right here coming up next the Rhino Report on KLRNradio.com. If you happen to be listening on one of the other affiliates, just check out local listings. I'm sure they've got great programming coming up right behind me as well. This is, of course, Vic Robinson. I'm your host here, and I'll be back with you again live tomorrow night for America Off the Rails. Take care.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey folks, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Hardin. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at rahardin.com. That's the World Wide Web at rahardin.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Hardin to see and purchase his books.